You're listening to The Archer's Omnibus from BBC Radio 4.
That was a lovely service.
Yes. I always enjoy the Harvest Festival. And such a beautiful day for it, too.
All the old traditions still in place. It's wonderful to come back after all these years and find that nothing has changed.
I'm not so sure about that, Carol.
Really? All the lovely autumn leaves and flowers, just as I remember. And the beautiful wheat-sheaf loaf as the centrepiece.
That is different. Fallon made it. Julene's daughter.
But that's wonderful. All the old traditional skills being passed on to the next generation.
I agree. But it is a bit of an advertisement for her burgeoning business.
Does that matter, Jill, if it keeps her in the village?
I hope it will. And at least that kind of business is an asset to the village, unlike Borchester land.
Well, yes. That hamper was just blatant.
If they think they can win us over with a few pots of speciality jam...
Which I'm sure the WI do much better.
Something they've ordered off the internet... Totally inappropriate.
Well, the poor of Ambridge certainly aren't going to get much sustenance out of foie gras and cheese straws.
Carol, there wasn't really any foie gras in there, was there?
Oh, might as well have been. Alan would do better to auction it and send the proceeds to the local food bank.
What a good idea. He could do it at the harvest supper.
Morning, Jill.
Oh,
and Mrs. Tregoran, is it?
Oh, Carol, please. And you are...
Hayley Tucker.
Oh, Roy's wife.
Yeah.
And Phoebe and Abby's mum. I imagine that's why you're here, isn't it?
Yeah.
Was one of them in the little play about the grain turning into bread?
Yeah. Abby was the loaf.
The star.
Yeah, she thinks so.
Alan's very good at getting the children involved. Is Roy here?
No. He had to work this morning.
Oh, what a pity.
Yeah.
How's he settling in at Grey Gables?
Fine. He was always very happy there. Caroline really appreciates him.
Elizabeth did too. I think she's missing his support with the arrangements for the Hunt Ball.
Is she?
That was Roy's initiative, wasn't it?
A lot of things were Roy's initiatives. Excuse me, I better go and find Abby.
Not quite the cheerful young woman everyone's told me about.
No. I do hope nothing's wrong. Roy's departure from Lower Loxley was rather a surprise.
So I gather.
I talked to Elizabeth about it, and she assured me that all these rumours about money are absolutely untrue.
I expect he just wanted to try out pastures new.
Maybe. But Elizabeth and Roy always got on so well. It does seem strange. Oh... I don't know what's the matter with my family at the moment.
Oh.
David's been unusually quiet all weekend.
Well, whatever it is, dear Jill, I'm sure you'll sort it out for them. But not until after lunch.
Well, that's the calves fed. What are you up to? Catching up on paperwork?
Nope. I'm looking for farms for sale near Prudder.
What?
Well, there's not much point us getting all wound up about the idea of moving. If there isn't anywhere for us to move to, is there?
But you consider it?
Very, very reluctantly. And only as a last resort. I mean, we don't even know if root beer be chosen.
It's not something I want to do. You know that. Thank you for taking me seriously.
Well, you made a good case. I wish I didn't think so, but I do.
So, have you found anywhere yet?
It was one that wasn't too bad.
No?
No, but not too bad isn't enough for us to turn our lives upside down for, is it?
Mm. this is delicious, Carol.
I do rather pride myself on my martinis.
Shaken, not stirred. I can't remember the last time I had a cocktail.
It's hardly a cocktail.
It is to me. And at this time of day, too.
Just think of it as an aperitif.
Yes, I will.
So tell me more about the harvest supper.
Well, I don't know that there's much to tell. Much as you remember it, I expect.
I remember your wonderful apple pies.
Thank you. Yes, I shall be bringing some of those.
Good.
More than usual, actually. They seem to be the main pudding.
I should hope they are.
I just hope I'll be able to get enough done in time.
Do you need a hand? I don't have your touch with pastry, but I could be your sous chef. Chop the apples, that sort of thing.
That would be very kind.
Nonsense. I'd like to contribute something.
It's still kind.
Everyone seems to be doing something. Bert said he's part of the entertainment.
Is he? He isn't going to read a poem.
I don't know. He was saying something about a small singing group.
Oh, yes. Bert, Joe and Eddie. I'd forgotten about that.
He seems to be taking it very seriously. Lots of rehearsals at this cider shed or whatever it is.
I imagine that's Joe and Eddie's idea. They may not be taking it quite so seriously.
Oh, dear. That won't play well with Bert.
No. Though, to be fair, Eddie can sing. I'm not so sure about the other two.
Well, hi, love. Is there anything I can do to help?
Not really.
Did you, have a chance to have that talk to Phoebe?
Yeah.
Any clearer why she's so angry with the both of us?
Not both of us.
Right. Just me, then. Hayley, that isn't because...
I know it must be hard for you, coming home to two angry women.
I didn't say that.
Well, it must be. When you've been so used to being so indispensable to Elizabeth.
Oh, Hayley, please, I never was, and...
Oh, apparently you were. Elizabeth's really struggling with the arrangements for your hunt ball.
It wasn't just mine. Is she? How do you know?
Jill mentioned it.
Really? Must be something pretty big. Jill knows about it.
She didn't say.
I wonder if it's the band. I mean, I told her she needed to get on with booking them. They're very popular, but, I mean, I did leave a list of...
Don't believe it. You still care, don't you?
Only professionally. If Elizabeth makes a mess of this...
Let her! Serve her right! What's it to you?
It might reflect badly on me.
You still care about her?
No. No, I don't. Now, please try to believe me. How can we move on?
I was trying so hard. Until Phoebe told me she knew all about it.
Oh, Hayley... Then that's why...
Yes! That's why.
Yeah, this is interesting.
Well, I thought you'd think so.
450 acres. That's about what we'd want, isn't it?
Yeah, it is.
Mixed farm.
Yep.
And the farmhouse is lovely. That gorgeous Northumbrian stone.
Yeah, well, bear in mind, estate agents are paid to take flattering photographs of properties they're selling.
Come on, David, you can't fake that glow.
Well, I bet you could. But I'll admit it does look like the real thing.
Of course it is. I should know.
Buildings don't look brilliant. It's hard to tell.
There's one way to find out. Go and look at it.
What, this week?
Well, that's the next step, surely.
Well, you are going up to Prudder anyway, I suppose.
Exactly. Perfect timing.
Do you think you'll have time, though? I mean, you've got to settle your mum back in at home when she comes out of hospital.
I will, if you will come with me.
Oh.
Well, in the unlikely event this ever happens... I presume you're planning to live in the farmhouse with me. Or is it just for me and Mum?
Well, I suppose I could come.
Yeah. Eddie's covering for me anyway, and I'm sure Pip can be more available.
we wouldn't tell her why we were going
there. No, of course not. We wouldn't need to. She knows about Mum anyway.
And we'd only be away for a few days.
We could look at the other farm too, just in case.
Mm. If they're not suitable, the sooner we know the better.
Yeah.
Right, well, that sounds like a plan.
Okay.
There is just one thing.
I know, we should check with Pip first, but I'm sure it won't be a problem.
No, I wasn't thinking about Pip, I was thinking about Mum.
I can't take it in. How long has she known, did she say?
Just last week.
Why didn't you tell me? Why didn't you tell me straight away?
Have you any idea what it was like for me to have to listen to our child telling me that you... that you...
Oh, Hayley, I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry.
Don't touch me.
It must have been terrible.
It was. I keep thinking this can't get any worse. And then it does.
She must hate me. What am I going to say to her?
Nothing. Just don't say anything.
Really? Won't that look like... I don't want to face her.
Do you think she wants to face you?
No. No, of course she doesn't.
She needs time to take it in. I know I did.
Yeah.
Anything you said now would be wrong.
Yeah, thank you.
Please, don't thank me.
Well, I'd have done it all wrong. I need time to take it in too, to see if there's any way I can make her understand.
Well, there isn't. Just say you're sorry. That's all you can do.
Yeah, if she'll let me.
You just have to wait and see.
I wonder if there's anything we can do together.
Do? I don't think she's in the mood to go tenpin bowling with you.
As a family, I meant. Just something normal.
Normal? I wish I thought there was.
There must be. I mean, we could go to the harvest supper.
The harvest supper?
Yeah, it would be a night out for all of us.
She probably wouldn't want to come even if things were normal.
Yeah, but she would if Dad and Vicky and Bethany were coming. I mean, you know, she wants to see as much of Bethany as she can before they move.
Well, yeah, she does.
Well, would she come if they were going? I know she would.
Well, maybe.
Well, please, Hayley, please. I need to make things right with Phoebe.
Oh, we just thought it'd be nice enough for us to sit out this time of year.
Yeah, no.
So are you taking the day off for...
Timing, Lou. Actually, I'm spending the morning job hunting online.
Well, you're not leaving Lower Loxley too.
Well, with Roy not working there anymore, it seemed simpler.
But you love your job.
I did.
Was it because... I mean, I hope you don't mind me asking, but... have Elizabeth and Roy fallen out? Is that what this is all about?
No, not really. It's complicated.
I see.
Anyway, Roy wanted me to ask you something.
Oh, well, fire away.
He wondered if you and Mike and Beth were going to the harvest supper on Friday.
Well, we hadn't really thought about it.
No.
Now, to be honest with you... Sounds awful, I know, but... Well, there doesn't seem to be much point in getting involved in these village events now we're moving.
That's what I thought.
And Beth can get a bit fractious in the evening.
Of course. I'm not sure that Abby will last the course either.
You're definitely going then?
Well, Roy seems set on it.
Oh, I suppose I could ask Mike.
Don't worry about it.
Yeah, but if Roy's so keen...
He's just got this fantasy of a great big family outing. It was never going to work.
He must have a reason.
Things have been difficult since he left Lower Loxley.
Yeah.
But I don't think being out at the harvest supper is going to help, however many people come.
Well, it would show the village a united front.
Why would we want to do that?
Well, because... Oh, I didn't know whether I should tell you this.
You have to now.
There are rumours going round about why Roy left Lower Loxley.
Yeah.
People are saying that he'd been fiddling the books.
What?
Well,
Of course we've been putting people straight about that.
Thank you.
How dare they? I mean, Roy would never do a thing like that.
About as likely as what he did do.
Hayley, what do you mean?
The real reason Roy left Lower Loxley. He's been having an affair with Elizabeth Pargeter.
All right, that's you done. Off you go.
Oh, dear. She didn't like that, did she?
It's got to be done. Can't really hurt that much.
And you like having your ears pierced, I suppose.
Well, I wouldn't know, Mum.
I wondered if you'd got time to come in for coffee. You've been so busy this morning.
Oh, it's the time of year, isn't it? All the calves.
I can easily bring you out a flask if you'd like.
No, that's all right. I'll just get this lot done and then I'll come in.
Right, well.
You're not going out this morning, are you?
No. I was just going to have some coffee myself.
Good. There's something I want to talk to you about.
You poor love. How could he do that to you?
Not just me.
And all for what? A bit of a fling?
I think it was more than that.
Do you?
He must really care for her, Vicky. Or it wouldn't have happened in the first place.
And what about Elizabeth? Did she feel the same?
I don't know. They were supposed to be caught up in the moment.
Oh, for heaven's sake, they're not teenagers. What was she thinking? She's your friend.
Roy's my husband, but that didn't stop him. That's why I think it must have been serious.
But it's over now.
He says it is.
But if he's left Lower Loxley...
I don't know what to believe. There's so much he's not telling me.
Still?
Yeah. How long it's been going on. Why it ended.
I see.
He claimed it was a one-off. I never thought that was likely.
No.
And now... Well, now I know that can't be true.
Tell him then.
I can't. I can't bear it if he lies to me again.
No.
I wouldn't get a straight answer out of him anyway. He'd just look hurt and hounded and say we need to move on.
It's easier said than done.
How can I move on when I don't know the truth?
You can't. It's the least you deserve.
Thank you.
No, it is. And if Roy won't tell you, you'll just have to ask Elizabeth.
Elizabeth?
Well, it takes two to tango.
It's so nice to be having coffee together for once.
Yeah. And while Charlie the Cat's in London going to meetings set up by the big bad wolf, Justin Elliot...
Rob, you're not telling Henry stories now.
No, don't stop me. I'm on a roll. Rob, the poor downtrodden mouse...
Oh, yeah.
...can come and see how Chief Nurse Helen and very important patient Henry are getting on.
Well, we're all the better for seeing you.
Yeah, he did seem a lot brighter.
Yeah, still tires easily, though. I'm surprised you needed a morning nap.
Well, he had a better night last night.
Ah, we all did. Darling, thank you for all those times you sat up with him.
Don't be silly.
But you had work in the morning.
Oh, well, work. I know what's important. It's been a worrying time, but we've come through it.
Yeah. I suppose I ought to be thinking about going back to the shop.
There's no rush, is there?
Well, I was thinking I'd like to leave it till next week. You know, make sure he's completely better.
Sounds like a good idea.
Oh, you don't think it's a bit self-indulgent?
How can putting your child's welfare first possibly be described as self-indulgent?
Well, I'd be happier.
Well, do it then.
What about Tina?
Well, every time I popped in, she seemed to be positively relishing having the place to herself.
Really?
Yeah. And your mum and dad haven't got any complaints about her, have they?
No, they like her. They think she's very efficient.
Well, there you are then. Everybody's happy.
Sounds like it.
Yeah, Henry certainly will be, having his mum at home with him for a bit longer. It's a precious time while he's so little.
Yes.
Right. I suppose I better get back to work.
Yep, I suppose you better had.
But I think I might be able to come back for lunch, if that's all right with you.
Of course it is.
So that's the reason I've decided to go with Ruth.
To look at these farms?
Yeah, and to help her settle her mum in.
Yes, of course. When are you going?
Tomorrow. That was always when Ruth was going.
Oh, of course it was, sorry. I don't seem to be thinking straight.
You do look a bit dazed.
I can't take it in. The idea of you looking at other farms.
Mum, I said it's only a backup plan. We felt we needed one, just in case, God forbid, Route B is the one they choose.
I suppose that's sensible. But to think of leaving Brookfield.
I know, but we are just looking, and if it wasn't for Heather, we probably wouldn't be considering it at all.
I know it's hard for Ruth. I can see it would solve a lot of problems for her.
She's really worried about her mum. I had to at least look for her sake.
Of course you did.
But between you and me, I'm hoping they won't be suitable and then we can forget all about it.
There'll be others.
Yeah, I suppose so.
You must go with an open mind.
Well, that's so generous. I can see it's been a shock for you.
There are so many implications.
I know.
What about the children's schools?
Yeah, no, well, we'll look into that, of course. And if there's nothing suitable, then the idea's off the table.
And were you thinking that I'd come with you?
Mum, I'm not thinking anything, not until I've seen the farms. There's no point.
I suppose not.
Promise me you won't brood about it. This really is a worst-case scenario.
It would be.
But Ruth is right. We do have to explore all the possibilities.
Of course you do. It's just, I never thought this would be one of them.
Are you sure there's nothing I can do to help?
No, just needs another 5 minutes.
Oh, it smells delicious, whatever it is. At least let me lay the table.
Oh, I've nearly finished. You just sit there and enjoy your coffee.
Oh, spoiling me.
Oh, it's nice to have you here for lunch. So, did you get hold of Adam?
Yeah, though it was Charlie you wanted, really.
Mm. When will he be back?
That's what Adam wanted to know. Sometime later this week, that's all he said.
What does Adam want to see him about?
He didn't say, but I expect it's about the home farm contract.
Oh, poor Adam. How unsettling.
Well, at least he's finished the maize harvest. Do you want me to go and see if Henry's awake?
No, not just yet. There's something I want to talk about.
Oh, yeah?
It's about me going back to work.
Oh, have you decided to give it another week?
A bit longer than that. Henry being so ill, it's really shaken me.
Yeah, I know, sweetheart, but he's better now.
It's made me question my priorities.
Really? You put Henry first, you always do.
Do I? Why am I missing this special time with him?
Oh, I see.
It goes so quickly. I mean, it just seems like only yesterday he was a baby. Before we know it, he'll be at school.
Oh, yeah, he's growing up fast.
And I can go back to work then. I should be here with him now.
What?
When I thought about it, I mean, really thought about it, it's not just that I don't want to leave Henry till he's better. I don't want to leave him at all.
But your career, you've invested so much in it.
I'll only be taking a break. Lots of women do.
And what about organics? You built it up. It was your baby.
Yeah, and now I have a real one.
Yeah, but it was so important to you. You can't tell me it wasn't.
It was once, but everything's changed now Tom and Kirsty have gone.
Really? It makes that much difference?
Yeah, it does. I felt I had to carry on for Mum and Dad's sake, but my heart's not in it.
Are you sure?
Yes. You and Henry, the centre of my world now. It's you I want to spend my time with.
This is so sudden. Are you sure you're not just reacting to Henry being ill?
It's not that sudden. I can tell you now.
Tell me what?
When you pick up Henry from nursery, when you get to see the pictures he's drawn and hear who he's played with today, I get jealous. I want it to be me. I know that sounds awful.
It's not awful. It's the most natural thing in the world. It's called being a mother.
Rob, I knew you'd understand.
Well, now I can tell you something. When I pick Henry up from nursery, the first thing he says is, "Where's Mummy?"
Really?
Yeah. Isn't she coming today? I haven't told you because I didn't want to guilt trip you.
This isn't about guilt. This is what I want. I just don't know why it's taken me so long to realise it. Right.
Right, so have you got everything now?
I think so. right, keys, purse, slippy. Where was my phone?
Well, where you last left it, I expect.
Yeah, but where was that?
Helen, Alice, just the people I wanted to see.
Oh, just on our way out, actually.
Well, I won't keep you long. It's about the auditions for the Christmas show.
Blimey, is it that time of year already?
I'm afraid so. Only they are tomorrow night, and I don't see your names on my list.
Rumpelstiltskin, Linda. I'm sorry, it just doesn't grab me.
Yeah, there can't be that many parts, can there? It's a pretty basic story.
But that's just what makes it so exciting. I've been able to expand on it. It has so many rich possibilities.
Really?
My main theme is the contrast between the life of the poor, hard-working family of the miller's daughter and the pampered, spoilt life of the rich prince.
Oh, you have expanded on it.
No, it has such contemporary relevance in these times of growing inequality.
It doesn't sound very Christmassy, though.
No! All I can remember about the story is that it used to give me nightmares.
Oh, yeah, that horrible little gnome thing. Oh.
Well, all fairy stories have a dark side, Alice. It enables children to work out their psychological conflicts.
Just made me scared of small men.
But you can draw on those nightmares, Fallon, to give depth to your performance as the miller's daughter.
But isn't she the heroine?
Indeed she is. She brings her prince to an appreciation of the true values of the simple life.
That's not what I remember.
I couldn't take the main role. I've got too much on with work.
But you'd be perfect. I could cast Harrison, too.
Oh, but Linda, I don't think that's a very good idea.
Of course it is.
Excuse me, I've got to find my phone.
Oh, have I said something wrong?
I did try to warn you.
I thought they were an item.
No, not anymore.
Oh, dear. That is a pity. Still, onward and upward. Would you like to be the miller's daughter, Alice? Can Christopher sing?
Is he asleep?
Yes, bless him. His eyelids were drooping before I got halfway through the story.
Oh. How do you think he is?
Much better.
Oh, good. I thought so too.
You look a lot more relaxed as well. Putting your feet up with a book.
Well, I'm going to be able to do much more of that now.
Oh, of course, now Henry's on the mend.
Not just that. Well, I'm glad you could come round this evening.
So am I. Seems ages since we had an evening just to ourselves.
Well, I hope there are going to be a few more of those too.
You're being rather mysterious. Is there something you're trying to tell me?
Yes. I've decided to give up work.
I can't believe she didn't know. You'd have thought someone would have told her.
Oh, forget it. We've come out to enjoy ourselves, remember?
Yes. I'm not going to let Harrison Burns spoil my evening.
That was the idea. Well, it's a pity the others couldn't come.
Emma's broke. She spent all her spare cash in France, mainly on presents for the kids.
Oh, it sounds like you had a great time. Oh,
she was in her element. You know, said it made up for missing the school exchange when she was 12.
Oh, bless.
Shame Hayley didn't feel up to it tonight. She could have done with a night out.
Yeah. Do you think there's any truth in these rumours about Roy?
No. The idea that he'd have his hand in the till, it's ridiculous.
Yeah, I know. Well, no surprise we couldn't persuade Helen to leave the love nest.
She's quite the home bird these days, isn't she?
Of course I'll still make the cheese, Mum. You don't have to worry about that.
That is the least of my worries.
As long as you can have Henry for me.
Of course we can. We can have him more if you don't want him to be at nursery so much.
Thanks, Mum, but that won't be necessary. I'll be here for him.
But you are now. You don't have to give up work.
Not in the way I want to be.
But abandoning Ambridge Organics like this?
Tina will take very good care of the shop. And we still have the final say in all the big decisions.
And that'll be enough for you?
It'll be enough for Bridge Farm. It won't change anything.
How can you say that? It's a family business. If you're not working with
you'll
us,
you'll get used to it. You've got used to Tom leaving.
No, I haven't.
No, I'm sorry, Mum. It's a silly thing to say. I haven't got used to Kirsty not being here either.
It's been such a tough time for all of us, but I thought we were coming through it. If that's why you're
going... Everything's so different. Bridge Farm too, now you've got Johnny there.
He's not a substitute for you or Tom. Surely that's not what you think, why you're...
No, I'm glad he's here. I'm really happy for you and Dad. but it's helped me see things clearly. Henry is my priority now.
So, Jolene doesn't think there's much rehearsing going on.
Eddie, Joe and Bert in the cider shed. What do you think?
What is it they're supposed to be singing?
Selection of folk songs, I think.
Right.
That is, if they can agree on any. Mum reckons they spend most of their time talking about Carol Tregoran.
Really? Why?
Joe fancies his chances with her.
Oh, you are joking.
I'm not. So he keeps trying to pump Bert for inside information.
Why would Bert know anything?
He's helping her with her garden. But he's very respectful of employer-employee confidentiality.
I should hope so.
Joe's not getting very far with him.
Well, I shouldn't think he'd get very far with Carol Tregoran.
She's very attractive.
Yeah, I know she is.
Though Eddie reckons it's her bank balance that Joe's really got his eye on.
Joe's about 110, isn't he?
93.
Oh, honestly, men. Oh. They never give up, do they?
Apparently not. Look, he's just walked in.
I can't believe she's doing this.
I gather that.
I just don't understand.
Maybe it was a pity you left so soon.
I had to go, Tony.
You were so looking forward to spending the evening with
Helen. I didn't know it was going to turn out like this.
If you'd stayed, she might have been able to explain a bit better.
There's no explanation that would make sense to me. I had to go before I said something unforgivable.
Like what?
Oh, take your pick. Why is she throwing her life away? Has she lost her mind? What's she planning to live on?
Well, I don't know.
She's financially independent. She's got an interesting career, a lovely and much-loved child, a man she seems to want.
I know.
Generations of women in the past. Many women in the world still now would think they'd died and gone to heaven if they had all that.
Maybe.
But not Helen. She wants to give it all up to play at being a 50s housewife.
It might be a bit more complicated.
Doesn't she know anything? Doesn't she know it was the life-draining boredom of that life, the lack of control over anything except what soap powder to use that led women to start second-wave feminism?
All that you're saying may be true, love, but...
But if Helen wants to turn the clock back, if my own daughter can still fall for this empty fantasy, what's it all been for?
Oh, love.
I'm serious, Tony. Where did we go wrong? Where did I go wrong?
I can't believe he'd bring her here.
Well, it's a free country.
But it's my favourite bar.
Well, maybe it's his as well.
He wouldn't even know about it if I hadn't brought him there.
Oh, perhaps we'd better just go there.
Well, haven't him and his airhead girlfriend spoiled my evening?
Well, haven't they spoilt it already? And you can't possibly tell she's an airhead from across the room.
Oh, I think I can.
Oh, why should that bother you?
It doesn't.
Well, then stop staring at them. You keep on like that, they're bound to notice and... Well, too late.
I can't believe it. He's coming over.
Oh, I warned you.
What does he want to do that for?
Say hello to some old friends.
Friends? Well, at least he hasn't had the nerve to bring her with him.
Well, maybe she didn't want to come. I wish I wasn't here myself.
Hey, you're not going anywhere. You've got to back me up.
Okay, well, let's just try to keep it civilised, shall we? Harrison! How lovely to see you.
Hi. You too, Alice. It's been ages.
Yeah.
Hi, Fallon.
Hi.
Haven't seen much of you either.
No, I've been busy. My business, you know.
Yeah. I heard your wheat sheaf loaf was the centrepiece of the Harvest Festival.
Yeah, people did seem to like it.
I'm sure they did.
Yeah, she's expanding, aren't you, Fallon?
Am I?
Yeah, you were in France last week.
Oh, yeah, so I was.
Ah, impressive. Exporting already.
More importing.
She went to a brocante.
Yeah, it was fascinating.
Sounds like a witchy Sabbath.
Well, it's an antiques market.
Bought out all the local stuff already?
Well, I'm just broadening my horizons, like you.
Okay, so what have you been up to, Harrison?
Oh, nothing special. You know, same old, same old.
Oh, making new friends, though.
What? Oh, Justine. Well, she's not that new, actually.
Justine?
They're keeping you busy at the station, then.
I'm afraid so. Justine says I'm never off duty.
Oh, well, maybe you better be getting back to her, then.
Yeah.
Yes.
Maybe I should. But it's good to see you both.
Yeah, good to see you too.
We'll all have to go for a drink sometime.
Oh, that'd be lovely, wouldn't it, Fallon?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, why not?
Great, good. Well, I'll see you around then.
Yeah, bye.
Bye. Why did you say that? I don't want to go for a drink with them.
Well, I had to say something. You've suddenly been struck dumb.
Because that is Justine.
I know. He said...
Justine's the one who dumped him on Valentine's Day.
So he's back with his ex?
If you could call her that. He said it was just a fling.
Well, he would if she'd just dumped him.
Well, I was right about her being an airhead then.
Oh.
I can't believe he's back with her after the things he said to me about her.
Obviously, he's changed his mind.
Obviously.
Which he's allowed to do. After all, you changed your mind about him, didn't you?
But could I just make an observation, as a mere male?
Of course you can.
It won't drive you away to live in some separatist feminist commune.
I probably couldn't find one. Go on.
Well, correct me if I'm wrong, but wasn't a woman's right to choose, in every area of her life, one of the things you and your contemporaries fought for?
Yes, it was.
Well, love, you may not like the choice Helen is making, but surely you have to respect it.
Oh, I would. Or at least I'd try if I thought it was her choice.
Well, who else? Oh, Pat. I thought we were trying to give Rob the benefit of the doubt.
Oh, it's a strange coincidence that Helen's new obsession with being a homemaker only started when she moved in with Rob.
Did she say her giving up work was Rob's idea?
Of course not. Yeah. Actually, she said he kept asking her if she was really sure.
Well, then.
Oh, Tony. He's far too clever to be that obvious. I know he's behind it.
Do you really think he could have so much influence on Helen? She's such a strong-minded girl.
That's what's so heartbreaking, Tony. She genuinely thinks it's her own idea.
I thought I'd get on with digging in the manure today, Mrs. Tregoran, if that's all right with you.
Of course.
I've managed to get some well-rotted stuff from the stables.
Excellent. Only the best for our new vegetable garden.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, well, I wanted to say, I think you've made a wonderful job of the raised beds.
Oh, really?
Oh, yes, I meant to mention it last week.
Well, I wasn't sure. I put in one extra.
Yes, I noticed.
I thought it was more symmetrical. But if you don't like it...
But I do. It's wonderful to be working with someone who uses his imagination.
Oh, it's a pleasure to have something I can really get stuck into.
Afternoon, Carol. Bert.
Ah, afternoon, Jill.
Jill. Sorry, is it 2 o'clock already?
Just about. Well, that was the time we said, wasn't it?
Yes, but I was having such a fascinating conversation with Bert about manure, I lost all track of time.
You really are enjoying yourselves, aren't you?
We are. I hope you're going to like what we do.
I'm sure I shall. And you couldn't have a better person to help you than Bert.
Oh, thank you. I was just telling Mrs. Tregoran it's a real privilege.
We'll leave you to it, Bert. Jill and I have got apple pies to make.
Ah, for the harvest supper. Yeah, should be a good night.
How's your little singing group getting on?
Oh, it'd be a lot better if Joe and Eddie had take my advice about the songs.
Things would usually be better if Joe and Eddie would take other people's advice.
Still, at least I'm reading one of my poems. They can't interfere with that.
You write poetry, Bert?
Oh, yes. Bert's quite our local bard.
Oh, village laureate, some say.
Really?
Yeah, on account of I write poems for special occasions, like the harvest supper.
Oh, I see. How clever.
Well, I do my best. Would you like to hear it?
We do really need to get on, Bert.
Yes, save it for the night. It'll be a surprise.
Oh, I'm glad you could see me, Jim.
Do sit down, Eddie. So, how can I help?
I was just up with the turkey poults.
By Jove, is it that time of year again? I suppose that means Linda will soon be persecuting us about her Christmas show.
Oh, she started already. Any road, it's Christmas I want to talk about. I think our promotion last year was a bit of a damp squib.
Oh, I don't remember it.
Yeah, exactly. So I want to make a splash this year.
I'm afraid I don't know much about poultry or marketing, come to that.
You know about the Romans, though?
I like to think so.
Well, they got up to all kinds of stuff, didn't they?
That's one way of putting it.
I just wondered if they used turkeys in any of their ceremonies. I mean, not the orgies or anything.
No, even the Romans might have found that a bit difficult.
So what do you reckon?
I'm sorry to disappoint you, Eddie, but the Romans couldn't use turkeys for anything. They wouldn't have known what they were.
Really?
Turkeys originated in Mexico, so they were unheard of in Europe until the 16th century.
Oh, is that when Columbus discovered Mexico, then?
Roughly speaking.
Oh, well, it was just a thought.
It's a pity you don't keep chickens.
The Romans had them, then.
The Roman gourmet Apicius had lots of recipes for chicken. Though I expect most people stuck to boiling them in sauce.
What else did they do?
Well, none of this modern squeamishness about only using the breast and the legs. They had recipes for every part of the chicken.
Did they?
Oh, yes. The stomach, the liver, the testicles.
Oh, I don't see it catching on. Offering the Pontus turkey testicles wasn't quite what I had in mind.
You're probably right. People nowadays are so picky.
They had a lot of festivals, the Romans, though, didn't they?
Oh, yes, they liked a good festival.
Did any of them involve chickens?
Not that I'm aware of. But I can certainly do a bit of research for you.
Thanks, I'd appreciate it.
You got me quite interested. Shall we discuss it over a pint at the Bull later?
So, after we've seen this farm, we should have a pretty straight run back south to Ambridge.
Well, fingers crossed it lives up to the estate agent's description.
Yeah, you weren't very impressed with the first one.
No, it was a perfectly nice little farm, but...
But not for us.
After Brookfield? No way.
Well, let's see this other one anyway.
Oh, thanks for coming with me, David. Mum was thrilled to see you.
Yeah.
I know this all feels like a last resort for you.
Yeah, it would be, except...
Except what? You like the bracing wind up here.
I had forgotten how lovely the countryside was.
Yeah, but that's not enough reason.
Well, to be honest, love, I was really shocked to see your mum. I know you've been telling me how frail she is, but to see her with my own eyes...
I know.
You know, you've been up here almost every week. It's been a gradual decline for you.
I suppose so.
I haven't seen her for a long time.
And she looked that different?
Well, it's quite a change.
Mum's adamant we mustn't move north just for her.
Well, we wouldn't. But it's a bigger factor than I thought it was going to be.
I'll chop another couple, do you think, Jill?
Yes, please. I'll start lining the tins with pastry.
Righto. So, do I gather Bert's poetry isn't that great?
Let's just say as a poet, Bert's a very good gardener.
Well, he's certainly that.
I'm glad you're getting on so well.
He is awesome. I just wish I could persuade him to unbend a bit.
How do you mean?
I've asked him so many times to call me Carol, but it's always Mrs. Tregoran.
It's what he thinks is proper.
It just seems so formal, and we have such a friendly working relationship.
Well, don't hold your breath. He called Phil boss for years.
I think I might prefer that.
But the day he does call you Carol, you will know you've really found a friend.
Well, I'm sure. I do wish he wouldn't feel he has to check things with me all the time.
That might be no bad thing.
But gardening's such a creative thing. I don't mind if he makes changes.
But you're his employer and you have the final say. That's how he'd see it.
I suppose.
It'll wear off. In a year from now, he'll be telling you what to do.
That might be going a bit far. Still, if it means I don't always have to be here when he's working.
That is a bit much.
Like this afternoon, I'm sure you'd rather be doing this in your own kitchen.
I was quite glad to get out, actually. A bit lonely with David and Ruth at her mum's.
Mm. When are they back?
Very late tonight. It's a long drive.
Oh. It must be a worry for Ruth having her mum so far away.
Mm. That might change.
Might it? How?
Well, everything's so uncertain at the moment.
You don't have to tell me if you don't want to, but... If there's anything on your mind...
It would be a relief to talk to someone about it.
So?
This would be in absolute confidence.
Of course.
It may never happen and I hope it doesn't.
Yes.
But if Rootby is accepted, well, David and Ruth might buy another farm near Prudder.
Leave Brookfield?
They wouldn't do it lightly. But the fact that they're even thinking about it...
must be a huge worry to you.
It is.
But surely... I mean, you wouldn't think of going with them.
I'm not sure. I haven't thought that far ahead.
You do know you're one of the reasons
I'd go so far as to say one of the chief reasons that I moved back to Ambridge.
Well, that's very flattering, though it does leave me with one slight problem.
What's that?
You're living in my house.
You turf me out any time you want. But I'm sure it won't ever come to that.
I hope not.
You leave Brookfield? It would be like the ravens leaving the tower.
Not that bad, I hope. The thought would never have crossed my mind.
And?
There's so much change. I sometimes feel Ambridge is becoming a place I don't recognise. And if Route B goes through, well, I may not want to live here anymore.
So have you got some good news for me?
Maybe. I don't know how I could have forgotten.
Well, the Romans did use chickens in their festivals.
Yes, they used them as oracles.
Oracles? You mean they told fortunes?
That's right.
How did they do that?
Well, people brought their questions to the attendants in charge of the sacred birds.
So that would be me and Dad?
If you say so. Then the attendants offered them beans or a special kind of cake.
Oh, I'm sure Clary could come up with something.
And if the chickens wouldn't come out of their cage or clucked loudly or flapped their wings or flew away, that was a bad omen.
Oh, I should think it would be.
But if they ate the offerings greedily, it was a good omen.
Oh, brilliant! Oh, we can do that.
Really?
Yeah. Oh, turkeys are very intelligent birds. They'll soon get the hang of it.
Well, they might. I'm not sure I do.
I'll charge an entrance fee to consult them. Throw in a glass of cider and a mince pie, maybe.
I think you'll have
that
to...
That entitles you to ask the turkeys one question.
I see.
And if you want more, you'll have to pay extra.
You really think that would be a major attraction?
Of course. Folks love having their fortunes told. I'll be coining it in.
It's hardly the Sibyl at Cumae, but I suppose it could work.
And once we've got them in, we can start taking orders for the turkeys. And the holly and mistletoe.
You think of everything.
I try. Oh, thanks, Prof. I owe you. I'll buy you a drink.
Evening, all.
Evening, Bert. Perfect timing. Eddie's just getting around in.
I said I'd buy you a drink. I didn't say anything about him.
Oh, charming. I reckon you owe me one. The grief you and your dad are giving me.
What have we done now?
Oh, you know what. Are you going to let me sing my song or not?
Admit it, that farmhouse was as lovely as it looked in the photos, inside and out.
It was very appealing.
And just the right size.
What, the farmhouse or the farm?
Both. 450 acres, just what we've been looking for.
If we were looking.
No, you don't fool me. You were just as impressed as I was.
Well, it would need some updating. New milking parlour for a start.
Well, we couldn't expect to find something perfect.
Some of the sheds had seen better days.
If it was your farm...
I'm just saying it could use some work. But overall, it was pretty tidy.
They were such a nice couple.
They don't come with the farm, you know.
So sad they have to sell it.
Well, they haven't got much choice, have they, if none of their children want to go into farming?
Four, though. You'd have thought one might take an interest.
Yeah. Yeah, that must be tough.
We are so lucky. We've got both Pip and Josh still keen on farming. And who knows about them, hmm?
I know.
We want to have a farm worth handing on to them.
Yes.
But is Brookfield going to be that farm if Route B goes through?
Oh, Ruth, I don't know. It would be such a big step. Uprooting ourselves.
Well, their village sounds pretty lively. I'm sure we'd get a warm welcome.
We certainly would from your mum.
Yeah, well, never mind about my mum. What about yours?
Oh, morning, Jill.
Morning. Someone looks peaceful.
We both got up very early to see Rob off hunting.
That was nice of you.
Henry insisted on seeing him all dressed up.
I'm sure he looked very smart. How is Henry now?
A lot better, thanks.
He looks it.
He still needs to take it easy for a bit longer.
Chicken pox is nasty. I remember when my twins caught it, it was a nightmare.
Oh, I can imagine. One sick child was quite enough for me.
Kenton would keep scratching his spots. Oh. He's still got a scar on his arm, I think.
Well, I want to keep Henry off nursery another week, just to be sure.
Will that make things difficult for you at work?
Nope. I'm giving up work.
What? Completely?
Yeah. My manager, Tina, is going to ring me this morning to finalise everything.
Right. That'll be a big change for you.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to it. I mean, take this morning. I can get a good lunch ready for Rob, and then Henry and I can hear all about what he's been doing.
Yes, that'll be nice for him.
Instead of me rushing in all tired at the end of the day, not being able to pay proper attention to anything.
It'll certainly give you more time.
To spend with Henry. That's why I'm doing it.
Morning, Jill, Helen.
Morning, Linda.
Look, I hope you don't think me rude. I'd love to stay and chat, but I need to get back before Tina calls.
Oh, no, 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 get off.
Nice to see you, Helen.
Yeah, and you. Bye.
Bye. Bye.
Oh, poor girl. Must be difficult for her at the moment, juggling work and a sick child.
So difficult, she's giving it up.
What, she's giving up work? I am surprised.
So am I.
She always seemed like such a career woman.
I know. I was surprised when she decided to have Henry.
I think we all were.
She says it's about spending more time with him.
Well, the most unlikely people do become devoted mothers. Look at Leonie.
Yes. Are you going to be able to see Mungo soon?
Yes, we're going down this weekend.
That's nice.
We're really looking forward to it.
They change so much at this age. And I suppose after that you'll be busy with the pantomime.
Oh, I doubt it. I don't have a cast, nor any prospect of finding one.
Linda, you always say that.
No, Jill, this is different. It really is. I'm in despair.
Oh, dear. Look, I'm afraid I've got to go too. David and Ruth didn't get back from Prada till late last night, and I've hardly seen them.
No, 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 you must get on, of course.
Maybe I could pop round later.
Well, would you? I'd appreciate that. You could come to lunch.
I'm sure she won't be long.
Well, I can't hang around. There's a lot needs doing this morning.
We need to talk to Jill first.
I know, I know.
And you need to calm down.
Well, it's hard. I still don't know what I'm going to say to her.
Well, we'll just tell her the facts. She can make up her own mind.
Make it sound so simple.
Hello, you two.
Hello.
Hi.
Oh, good. I was worried I might have missed you.
No, no, we're just having coffee.
I wasn't sure you'd have time for that. You must have so much to catch up with.
Well, that can wait.
I would have been back sooner, but I got talking to Helen and Linda.
Oh, that's all right. You're here now.
Poor Linda's in quite a state. I said I'd have lunch with her.
That's kind of you.
I hope that's all right. There's soup you can heat up.
No, it's fine. Why don't you just sit down?
I'll pour you a coffee.
Sorry. I suppose you want to tell me all about your visit.
Yes, we do.
Thank you, Tina. I'm very grateful. And I'm sure everything's going to work out fine. Yeah. I'll be in touch. Bye. Well, it's all sorted, Henry. Mummy can stay at home with you every day. Would you like that?
Yes!
Me too. There'll be so many lovely things we can do.
Yes, read me story.
Please?
Please.
Well, perhaps just one. But then we better start getting lunch ready, hadn't we? Rob will be hungry.
So there's all sorts of things going on in the village. A very active WI.
Very lively church, they said.
That's good to hear. It's hard for churches in such remote places.
It's not that remote.
No, of course not. And have you looked into schools at all?
There seem to be a few options there. All the farm children went to the closest one.
And they did very well.
But they didn't want to take over the farm.
Well, that was just their choice.
Not because there was anything wrong with it.
I'm sure there isn't. It sounds lovely.
It was, Jill. The farmhouse was so beautiful.
That old stone's very attractive.
And the farming is very much like here, really. But perhaps not so much dairy farming.
I can see you're both quite taken with it.
It was pretty special.
But all this, Mum, it's still very much a backup plan.
It's just a relief to have one.
I can see it is. Now, I think I ought to go and tidy up a bit before I go over to Linda's.
Oh, okay.
And you must have lots to do on the farm.
Well, there's no rush.
No, if there's anything else you want to ask us.
No, I don't think so. I'm pleased you had such a good trip.
Oh, dear.
I told you it wasn't going to be that simple.
She didn't say she hated the idea.
She didn't say much.
Well, she certainly didn't let on whether she'd be willing to come with us.
No.
Because it would affect your decision, wouldn't it?
Yes. Yes, it would.
So come on, Linda. What's the problem with the pantomime?
Oh, I don't know where to start.
How about with the auditions? They were this week. Didn't they go well?
They were a total disaster. Only two people turned up.
Oh, dear. Well, you've often had a slow start.
Slow? I think that's the worst turnout I've ever had.
Who did come?
Derek Fletcher and Molly Button.
Oh, I see.
Quite. Not the most talented thespians in our little community.
Molly can dance.
Yeah, she thinks she can.
Well, they were both obviously keen.
Oh, yes. Yes, they were keen. Derek Fletcher was keen to be the dame.
Oh, dear, was he?
Oh, don't worry. There isn't a dame in Rumpelstiltskin, Jill. And even if there was...
Quite. And Molly Button?
She wanted to be the principal boy.
I'm guessing there isn't one of those either.
No, of course there isn't. It's not that kind of show.
Well, as I said, you've had to drum up support before, and people have always responded in the end.
Not this year. Heaven knows I've been trying.
No luck?
No. Everyone says they're busy over Christmas.
I suppose they will be.
Well, the show's always at Christmas, Jill. It's never stopped them before.
I know. But these are difficult times, Linda.
I'm well aware of that.
Everyone has so much on their minds with all that's going on in the village.
Yes, I know, but I thought the show would bring the community together. Usually it does.
That's true.
Then why not this year?
You have been doing it for a very long time.
Exactly. It's an Ambridge tradition.
And you've done brilliantly well to keep people interested in it.
Well, clearly I failed this year. Perhaps I've chosen the wrong show.
All I'm saying is, would it be such a terrible thing to have a year off? It's not without precedent.
What? You mean not have any kind of show at all?
Only for a year? Let it lie fallow. People would come back with renewed energy, fresh ideas.
Well, that would certainly make a change.
You might even benefit from it yourself.
Well, maybe you're right. And why should I knock myself out trying to think of a different pantomime?
You usually have such enthusiasm. If that's gone...
It has. I've been in denial about it, I know, but it has.
You need a rest.
Yes, well... Well, that's it. There will be no Christmas show in Ambridge this year. Maybe not ever again.
That's a bit drastic. I only suggested a break.
Well, sometimes things come to an end, even very good things. One just has to accept it.
I suppose so.
Recognise that it's time to move on and find a new challenge.
Rob, Rob!
Let Rob get in through the door, darling.
Oh, this is a very nice welcome.
Rob!
Oh, Henry. No, I should let me go now. I'm a bit hot and sweaty.
You smell like horses.
I expect I do.
I expect Rob would like his bath now.
Well, a shower at least.
He wants to run you a bath.
I'm going to put bubbles in it. Lovely ones.
Oh, that would be lovely.
Can I show you my picture?
When Rob's had his bath, darling. Henry's drawn a lovely picture of you hunting.
Oh, my word, you have been busy.
I come with you next time.
Now look, I told you, not until you're a much bigger boy.
Yes, you'll have to learn to ride first, but when we get you a pony...
Rob.
Well, we will. Look, I tell you what, Henry, why don't you draw a picture of the pony you'd like while I have my bath?
Good idea.
Yes, I'll get my best crayon.
Well, you've started a fox running there.
Yeah, well then, Henry will need a pony to chase it, won't he?
Have you had a good morning?
Yes, thank you. And all the better for coming back to this idyll.
I wouldn't call it that.
No? Greeted by an affectionate and talented child and a beautiful and thoughtful fiancé ready to tempt me with a delicious meal.
How do you know it's going to be delicious?
Well, because you've cooked it.
You forgot the bubble bath.
No, is that a hint?
Well, Henry's right. You do smell of horse.
Sorry.
I don't mind. I don't mind at all.
David, I thought you'd be helping Ruth with the calves.
I was. I saw you come back. What are you doing?
Nothing. Just thinking.
Mum, I need to talk to you.
Yes, love. Go on, then.
About the farm in Pridder.
The backup plan.
How do you really feel about us moving there?
I don't know. How do you feel?
Well, I could never have imagined it would come to this. Not in a million years.
Neither could I.
And I hope it doesn't.
Of course.
The idea of leaving Brookfield. When I think about it, it's like having my heart wrenched out of
me. Oh, love.
I can't say that to Ruth.
No.
But it wouldn't be Brookfield, would it? Not anymore.
I've been thinking that myself.
Have you?
Yes.
And the thought of giving up farming, that's even worse.
Of course it is. It's your life.
Not having something worth handing on to the children.
Unbearable.
Oh, sorry. Oh, I shouldn't even ask you this. It's not fair.
Would I come with you?
Yes. Mum, it would be so hard for me. I don't know if I could do it unless you were there.
Oh, David.
But it must be your choice. You have to be honest with me. Could you leave Brookfield?
Come in. Oh, Hayley.
Afternoon, Elizabeth. I'm glad I caught you.
Well, actually, this isn't a very good time. Mum wants us all to go to the harvest supper.
Yeah, we're going too.
Well, she's very keen to make it a family occasion. I don't want to let her down.
But this won't take long. And don't worry, Elizabeth. I haven't come to have a row with you.
Good.
I just want the truth.
The truth?
Don't pretend that you don't know what I'm talking about.
I wasn't. But I don't know if I can help you.
I think you can. We were friends once. You owe me that, at least.
Yes. What do you want to know?
This, whatever it was between you and Roy, how long had it been going on?
It started at Greenbury Fields. But
yeah, I know. But was that the first time that you...
Yes. Yes, of course it was.
Of course.
It shouldn't have happened. Afterwards, we both
Never mind about afterwards. Before. There must have been a build-up.
No. No, honestly, Hayley, I never... I had no idea...
So Roy made the first move?
It's not fair to blame Roy. We were both equally guilty.
No. You weren't. You're not married.
But I was. And I have children. The damage this has done, if I could put the clock back...
You can't.
No, I can't.
So, after Greenbury Fields, it went on?
No, we both knew it couldn't.
I don't believe you. The way Roy's been and... Well, I know it was more than just a one-night stand.
Well, there was Loxfest, but...
Loxfest? Oh, Elizabeth... What is it about you two and festivals?
I'm sorry, it was supposed to be a goodbye.
Was it?
I thought Roy would have told you because... Well, that's when we knew it had to end.
You knew, Elizabeth. But did Roy?
Of course we should sing mine. It's the original Borsetshire version.
No, it's not.
Look, I'm older than you.
What's that got to do with anything?
Well, that stands to reason I'd have been taught the older version.
No, it don't. I was taught it by my great-grandfather.
And I was taught by mine.
Well, I think my great-grandfather might have had a better memory than yours.
Yeah, and why would you say that?
Well, he probably didn't drink as much cider.
Oh, don't you insult my great-grandfather. I'll have you know he was a primitive Methodist.
Ready for the sound check? It's all set up.
Well, we haven't decided which version we're starting with yet.
Oh, you're not still on about that.
The honour of the Grundy's at stake.
Oh, come off it, Dad. It's only a song.
song, so you'll sing my version, will you, Eddie?
Can't. I don't know the one, Dad, too.
Ah, exactly. It's been handed down from generation to generation.
Good evening, gentlemen. All ready for your big night?
Oh, doesn't look like it.
I'm not going on unless we sing my version.
And I ain't going on unless we sings mine.
Oh, but you're the reason I've come. You mustn't disappoint me.
Well, I don't want to, Mrs. Tregoran, but he's so stubborn.
I am. We're singing John Barleycorn, and there are several different versions.
Well, of course. It's a folk song. I expect there's a particular Borsetshire version.
Ah, there isn't. It's mine.
No, it isn't. It's mine.
We won't be singing anything unless we get this sound check done.
Good evening, everybody. Oh, sorry I'm late, Carol.
That's all right. Gentlemen, I'm sure there must be an amicable way out of this. Look, why don't you go and do your sound check and I'll give it some thought.
Good idea. Now, come on.
All right. I'm sure you'll make the right choice, Mrs. Tregoran.
Ah, clever woman like you will get in the sea sense.
Oh, dear. What's all that about?
Artistic differences. Are you all right, Jill? You look a bit stressed.
I've been trying to round up the family. I thought it would be nice if we could all come tonight.
Lovely. Did you succeed?
Yes, I did, which is a minor miracle. Oh, excuse me. Oh,
take it. I'll start unloading the pies.
Hi, love. You okay?
No, Mum, I'm not. That's why I'm ringing. I'm afraid we won't be able to come tonight after all.
Oh, Elizabeth, why not?
I've got a dreadful headache. It came on really suddenly.
Oh, I'm sorry. You don't sound good. Is there anything I can do?
No. Just enjoy your evening.
I'm sorry. I know I'm really late, only I've had the day from hell. Just about put the tin lid on it.
It's all right.
Oh, good. You looking for something to wear? I mean, we can still go. Won't I miss much?
Don't worry about it.
Only I have to tell you something before we do.
It's a coincidence.
Now, don't be cross with me.
I won't.
I can't carry on at Grey Gables anymore. It's just not working out.
Oh, it's up to you.
Well, it'll have implications for all of us.
I don't care. I don't care what you do.
What do you mean? Hayley, what are you doing?
I'm packing. I've got to get away.
Well, tonight? But the harvest supper...
I can't sit there with you and Phoebe and Abby pretending we're a family.
But we are.
I can't do it anymore.
You don't have to go, please. Hayley! God, you're frightening me.
I can't. Not now I've spoken to Elizabeth.
What? But why?
I needed to know the truth.
I told you the truth.
No, you didn't. You didn't say you'd fallen in love with her.
I hadn't. It was just...
Oh, please, don't tell me it was just a moment of madness. Or, to be accurate, two moments of madness.
If this is about Loxfest, I can explain.
No, it's not the sex, Roy. I could probably have recovered from that.
I know, I should have told you, but...
But you didn't. Because you're still in love with her.
No! Well, of course I had feelings for her, or it wouldn't have happened, but that's all over. I told you it was.
It's over because Elizabeth didn't want to do any more damage to her children.
Well, yeah, that was part of it, of
and
course.
And neither do I. I've seen what this has done to Freddie and Phoebe, and I'm not putting Abby through it. I'm taking her to my mum's.
But Hayley!
You don't need to worry about Phoebe. She's gone to her friend's for the weekend.
So when will you be back? You just need time to think?
Yeah. I need time to think what I do now our marriage is over.
I've told you, I'm not going on.
Oh, that's fine. Me and Eddie will just sing it as a duet.
Oh, good. I've caught you before you go on.
I'm not sure we shall be going on at this rate.
It is a knotty problem, but I may have found a solution.
Oh, I hope so.
Well, go on. We're listening.
Well, you're all so intent on authenticity. The thing is, I think you're forgetting your audience. I think Ambridge deserves to hear both versions.
Right, but how will we fit them in?
I'm sure your audience will want an encore.
Oh, are they? Definitely will.
So my suggestion is that you do Joe's version to start with.
Why Joe's?
So that you can save yours for the encore, Bert, as a solo.
Brilliant.
Yes, I was rather pleased with it myself.
So Carol's gone to see if she can sort it out.
Honestly... They could fall out over anything, that pair.
They can.
Are you all right, Mum? You seem a bit distracted.
I'm worried about Elizabeth.
She sounded terrible on the phone.
Yeah, it's a real shame she couldn't make it. Is that the only thing that's bothering you? You're not thinking about...
No, David, not about that. Oh, look, here's Carol now. So, have you talked sense into them?
I hope so. We shall soon find out.
Evening, ladies and gentlemen, and a warm welcome to our Harvest Supper Entertainment. We thought we'd start with that great old favourite, John Barleycorn.
There were three men came out of the west, their fortunes for to try. And these three men made a solemn vow, John Barleycorn must die.
Oh, Hayley, please. Please, don't do this.
It's no good, Roy. I've got to go.
For the weekend, maybe. But not forever.
Don't make this harder for me than it is.
I love you and the children. I'll try. I want it to work. You know how much I want it.
It's no good.
Believe me. You must believe me.
I do. But wanting and trying, it isn't enough.
Oh, don't say that. Look, we can't be over. We can't.
You left me when you fell in love with Elizabeth. And I can't go on pretending anymore.
And now for another old favourite.
It's going well, isn't it?
I'm sure you'll all know it.
Thanks to you.
Which is just as well, because we want you to join in the chorus.
I don't know what you said to them, but it certainly seems to have worked.
Bringing in the sheaves.
Oh.
OK.
You all right, Mum?
It was Doris's favourite harvest hymn.
Really? Oh, dear Doris.
Phil loved it, too. Oh, heavens.
What's the matter, Mum?
Nothing. I just felt a bit giddy, that's all.
Do you want me to take you home?
I just need some air. It's hot in here.
Don't worry, David, I'll take her outside.
Now come on, everybody.
Bringing in the sheaves, bringing in the sheaves. We shall come rejoicing, bringing in the sheaves, bringing in the sheaves.
Are you feeling any better, Jill? Shall I get you some water?
No, I'm fine. I just needed some air. Oh,
it was that song, wasn't it? Doris's favourite.
Yes. I suddenly saw her so clearly. She used to sing it while she was kneading bread.
Did she?
Yes. She said it had a good rhythm to it. Doris in Brookfield Kitchen. It belonged to her.
Yes. It was her realm.
I never thought it would be mine.
I can imagine.
Neither did she.
Oh, Jill, she loved you.
I know.
She was very proud of what you and Phil achieved.
I hope so. But giving up Brookfield was very hard for her.
I know.
I'm not sure she ever came to terms with it.
Well, Glebe Cottage is lovely. I should know.
Yes. I was happy there with Phil. But Doris... Brookfield was everything to her.
Is this really about Doris?
Of course it isn't. You know I said David and Ruth were looking at a farm up north?
Yes.
They found one. Really liked it.
Ah.
And yesterday David asked me, if they had to go, whether I'd go with them.
And you said yes.
Carol, I had to. The way he was talking about it broke my heart. I couldn't leave him to face that alone. But tonight...
You changed your mind?
I don't know. Sitting there at the harvest supper, surrounded by all my friends and family, seeing all the good things Ambridge means to me.
You don't have to sell it to me. I came back.
I don't think I can leave. Not even for David.
Oh, Jill.
I'm like Doris. I'm too old to start again.
Thank you.
Is Ambridge your specialist subject? Try the quiz at bbc.co.uk/archers.